Good morning, students. Welcome to today's online class. In today's class, we have to discuss about first concept means combination of inductors. Inductor means a device which is used to induce EMF, or it is a device used to store some magnetic energy. That kind of device is called as a inductor. Here mainly two types of combination of inductors are there. The first combination is called a series combination of inductors, and second one is called as parallel combination of inductors are there. When two inductors are joined in series, what is effective inductance? When two inductors are joined in parallel, what is effective inductance is there? So that is about first concepts we have to discuss. So out of two combinations, the first combination is called a series combination of inductors. Series means, you know, end to end combination, side by side combination. Assume it is first inductor whose inductance is L1. It is connected to second inductor whose inductance is L2. So L1 and L2 are two inductors. Both are joined in series. At the ends of series combination, the battery is connected. Battery always provides some EMF. The potential difference across open terminals of the service is called as EMF. So, you know, in series combination, I current coming from the source passing through first inductor. The same I current is also passing through second inductor. So, in case of series combination, the current passing through two inductors is same. That means rate of change of current passing through two inductors is same. So in series combination, the applied EMF is divided into two parts. Some part of EMF developed across first inductor, and second part of inductor E2 is developed across second inductor. So in series combination, current is same, but in series combination, potential difference on EMF is divided. So applied EMF E is equal to E1 plus E2. Where E is called as induced EMF in self induction. So according to this formula, induced EMF in self induction, E1 is equal to minus L1 into DI1 by DT. And E2 is equal to induced EMF across second inductor is nothing but minus L2 into DI by DT. So apply E1 value, E2 value in equation 1. E means minus L into DI by DT is equal to E1 means minus L1 into DI by DT plus E2 means it is also minus L2 into DI by DT. In all the terms, DI by DT is common and cancel. So minus L is equal to minus L1 plus minus L2 is there. Or minus is common and cancel. So when two inductors are joined in series, the effective inductance L is equal to L1 plus L2. So that is about expression for effective inductance in series combination. L1 is first inductor, L2 is second inductor. The effective inductance becomes L1 plus L2. Similarly, if three inductors are joined, the effective inductance becomes three inductors, effective inductance becomes L1 plus L2 plus L3. Four inductors are joined, L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus L4. So in series combination, effective inductance is increased. So that is about first kind of combination of inductors means series combination of capacitors. Next, second kind of combination of inductors means parallel combination of capacitors. The parallel combination is also called as face-to-face combination. So assume it is first inductor whose inductance is L1. It is second inductor whose inductance is L2. First ends of inductors are connected to one point and second ends of inductors are connected to another point. Such combination is called as parallel combination. At the ends of parallel combination, one source is applied. Source always has EMF. I current coming from the source reaches this point. At this point, I current divides into two parts, I1 and I2. I divides into some part of current is passing the first and second part, the remaining part of current is passing the second inductor. So, in this parallel combination, current divides system. Again, this I1 current and this I2 current combines and final I current. Incoming current and outgoing currents are always equal. But in parallel combination, the potential is same, that means EMF is same. So in case of parallel combination, effect applied EMF across the first inductor and second inductor remains the same. We know applied EMF means EB is equal to minus L into DI by DA. Our magnitude of induced EMF means plus L into dA by dt. Magnitude of anywhere is always positive. Or a dA by dt is equal to a E by L. A rate of change of current is nothing but E by L. So remember these conditions. So ultimately in parallel combination, EMF is same, but current divides. A total current coming from the source divides into two parts. I1 means current passing the first inductor, I2 means current passing the second inductor. Differentiating on both sides, left side differentiation is dI by dt is equal to differentiation of first term dI1 by dt and differentiation of second term dI2 by dt. Recorded original form dI by dt means E by L. So dI by dt means E by L. E is equal to dI1 by dt. dI1 by dt means E by L1. dI2 by dt means E by L2. In all the terms, the numerator E is common and cancel. Totally, when two inductors are joined in parallel, the effective inductance 1 by L is equal to 1 by L1 plus 1 by L2. Similarly, three inductors are joined in parallel, effective inductance is 1 by L1 plus 1 by L2 plus 1 by L2. Or simplifying this equation, 1 by L is equal to a right side LCM is L1 and L2. Your numerator L2 plus L. So this value is nothing but 1 by L. Or L is equal to L1 into L2 by L1 plus L2. Two inductors are joined in parallel. The effective inductance becomes L1 plus L2 by L1 into L2 by L1 plus L2. Or 1 by LP is equal to in parallel combination 1 by L1 plus 1 by L2. So that is about parallel combination of inductor system. And next continuation concept means mutual inductions. Mainly two types of induction. First induction means self-induction and second induction means mutual inductions. So what is meant by mutual induction? When current passes through one coil, it changes. A EMF is induced in another coil. Current passing the first coil, it changes. EMF is induced in second coil. Or current passes the second coil, it changes, EMF is induced in first coil. Such kind of phenomenon is called as a mutual induction. So mutual induction conclusion, when current passes through one coil, it changes, EMF is induced in another coil. So the phenomenon of inducing of EMF in one coil due to changing of current in another coil, such kind of phenomenon is called as mutual induction. So to explain mutual induction, totally we require two coils. So assume the first coil, at the ends of first coil, only galvanometer is connected. Where no current is passing, galvanometer shows zero differentiation. Next, it is called as primary coil. Nearer to primary coil, one more coil is called as secondary coil. At the ends of secondary coil, standard battery and pressing key is there. The standard battery BA pressing key is there. We know the meaning of pressing key. When key is pressed, the current passing through this coil is increased. Whenever current passing through coil is increased, flux linkage with the coil is also increased. Flux linkage with the coil changes means a EMF is induced. Again, key is open, current passing through coil is decreased. When current is decreased, flux linkage with the coil is also decreased. Whenever flux linkage with the coil is decreased, EMF is induced in another direction. So that is about here. Current is changing in one coil. Deflection of galvanometer takes place in one coil, other coils. A deflection of galvanometer indicates a inducing of EMF or current. Such kind of phenomenon is called as mutual induction. So assume initially constant current is passing through second coil. Every current carrying conductor produces magnetic field. Then constant current is passing. A constant flux is produced. The same constant flux is also linked with the primary coil. So assume I current is passing through first second coil. Constant current I is passing through second coil. Constant current is passing means constant flux is increased. But constant flux never produces EMF. Now galvanometer shows zero reflections. And constant current is passing, constant flux is needed. Galvanometer shows zero reflections. Now key is closed. When key is closed, current pass through the second coil is increased. Whenever current pass through the second coil is increased, the flux linkage with the primary coil is also increased. The flux linkage with the primary coil is increased, galvanometer shows reflection in one direction. Now again key is open. When key is open, current pass through the second coil is decreased. Current pass through the second coil is decreased means the flux linkage with the primary coil is also decreased. A decreasing flux can produce current in opposite directions. So totally current pass through the second coil changes. Galvanometer shows deflection in first coil. So inducing of EMF in one coil due to changing of current in another coil is called as a mutual induction. But according to diagram, the flux linkage in secondary coil, the flux linkage in primary coil depends on current pass through the secondary coil. The flux in primary coil is directly proportional to current pass through the second coil. More current is passing, more flux is increased. Less current is passing, less flux is increased. Or removing proportional, we get some proportionally constant M is there. As if it is equation 1. Where M is called as a proportionality constant. This proportionality constant in a mutual induction is called as a coefficient of a mutual induction. M is called as mutual coefficient of mutual induction, and it is also called as mutual inductance. So that is about equation 1. M is called as a coefficient of self-induction, it is called as mutual inductance system. By pressing the key or opening the key, current passes through the second coil changes. A flux linkage with the primary coil is also changes. Whenever flux linkage with the coil changes, EMF or current is induced. According to Faraday's second law, a induced EMF E is equal to minus d phi by dt. A induced EMF E is equal to minus d by dt of a flux. A phi means MI. A induced EMF in mutual induction E M is equal to E suffix M. E is equal to M is constant outside minus M into dI by dt. So that is about expression for induced EMF in mutual induction, where M is called as a mutual inductance or a mutual inductance or coefficient of mutual induction. Di by dt means rate of change of current. And a negative sign indicates the direction of induced EMF is always opposite to the rate of change of current or always opposite to the rate of change of flux. So that is about expression for mutual induction. induced MF in mutual inductions. Or from this M is equal to minus E by dI by dt. So from this equation we can define mutual inductances. If a dI by dt value is minus 1, if dI by dt value is minus 1, then mutual inductance M is equal to minus E by minus 1, minus minus cancel, M is equal to E. So from this condition we can define mutual inductances. Our definition means it is equal to the induced EMF when rate of change of current is minus 1 ampere per second. A rate of change of current is minus 1 ampere per second means rate of decreasing of current is there. If rate of decreasing of current is minus 1 ampere per second, the corresponding induced EMF is called as mutual inductance. And units of mutual inductance, units of self-inductance or mutual inductance is nothing but Henry. The symbol of Henry means H. And dimension formula of inductance, already previous variable, M is equal to, a dimension formula is nothing but M, L square, e power minus 2, I power minus 2. It is the dimension formula of mutual inductance. So that is about the phenomenon of mutual induction. When current passes through second coil changes, EMF is induced in first coil. The phenomenon of inducing of EMF in one coil due to changing of current in another coil. Such kind of phenomenon is called as mutual induction. And it is called as mutual inductance. And units of mutual inductance means Henry is there. A dimension formula is nothing but this one. Next, a continuation concept means expression for mutual inductance between two coaxial solenoids. Because to explain mutual induction we require two coils. But according to question, according to syllabus, the two coils are coaxis. A coaxis means two coils lies on same axis. So between two coaxial axis, between two coaxial solenoids, a derived expression for mutual inductance is there. So for this purpose, we assume the first solenoid, a first solenoid is named as S1. The length of the first solenoid is L length of the first solenoid having capital N1 number of turns, Then, a number of turns for unit length is nothing but capital N1 by L. Or, capital N1 is equal to small N1 into L. So, the first solenoid, geographical conditions. To the first solenoid, I1 current is passing. Then I1 current is passing the first solenoid. It can produce magnetic field along this axis. So field induction to the first solenoid. We know field induction to the first solenoid. Already previously we derived moving charges. Field induction to current carrying solenoid. P1 is equal to mu naught small N1. I1. Or that is equal to mu naught small n1 means capital N1 by L into I1. So every current carrying solenoid produces magnetic field, and current carrying solenoid is nothing but this. Next, second solenoid, assuming the second solenoid. But according to diagram, the two solenoids arranged coaxially, both are arranged coaxis, both have a common axis system. Its length is also L, but it has N2 number of turns. So in case of second solenoid, L length of second solenoid consisting of capital N2 number of turns. The number of turns for unit length of second solenoid small n2 is equal to capital N2 by L, or capital N2 is equal to small n2 into L. It is about relation capital N2 small n2. It is a relation capital N1 and small n1. Through the second solenoid, I some current is passing. Current carrying second solenoid is also produced some magnetic field. We know magnetic field induction of second solenoid B2 is equal to mu naught small n2 into L. Or mu naught small n2 means capital N2 by L into I. So that is about some conditions based on first solenoid and second solenoid. A number of turns for unit length of first solenoid and number of turns for unit length of second solenoid. Field induction of first solenoid and field induction of second solenoid. But here we have to explain mutual induction. Mutual induction means we know when current passes through one first coil changes, EMF is induced in second coil. Or current pass in the second coil changes, EMF is induced in the first coil. Assume I1 current pass in the first coil can produce a phi 2 flux in second coil. So flux link in second coil depends on current pass in the first coil. Because mutual induction and current pass, I2 be the current pass in the second solenoid and phi 1 be the flux link in first coil. So flux link in first coil depends on current pass in second coil. So recall based on mutual. So that is about conditions in first coil and conditions in second coil. Next continuation means we know the flux in primary. I assume a flux in primary depends on current pass in secondary. And flux in secondary depends on current in primary, because it is mainly based on mutual induction. The flux linked in one coil depends on current pass in the other coil. So according to this, based on mutual induction, the flux in primary phi 1, a coil means N1. So flux in primary coil, flux in first solenoid N1, phi 1 is equal to, the flux in one coil depends on current pass in the second one. It is equal to M into I. Here M means mutual inductance of first solenoid with respect to second solenoid. So N1 into phi 1 means when flux in first coil depends on field in second coil. Phi 1 means B2A, a flux of phi is equal to BA, is equal to M12 into I. So capital M1 into B2 means we know field induction second solenoid, mu naught capital N2 by L into A. Mu naught N2 by L into I2 into A is equal to M12 into I2. Both sides I2 and I2 cancel. So expression for mutual inductance of first solenoid with respect to second solenoid, M12 is equal to mu naught N1 N2 capital M1 capital M2 into A by L. It is the expression for mutual inductance between two solenoids in terms of N1 and N2. Or that is equal to mu naught small N1 small N2 into A. It is the expression for mutual inductance of a first solenoid with respect to second solenoid in terms of capital N1 capital N2. It is in terms of small N1 small N2. So that is about mutual inductance of first solenoid with respect to second solenoid. Similarly, the mutual inductance of second solenoid with respect to first solenoid. A mutual inductance of second solenoid with respect to first solenoid. nothing but m to 1 mutual inductance of second solenoid with respect to first solenoid. But according to this flux link in second coil depends on current pass in the primary coil. The total flux in second coil means n2 phi 2 is depends on current pass in the current pass in the first one, m into i1. M means mutual inductance of second coil with respect to first coil. R that is equal to N2 into the flux in secondary coil. Phi 2 is equal to phi means BA. A flux in second coil depends on field in first one. A B1A is equal to M21 into I1. So capital N2 into B1 means field induction to first solenoid. A mu naught capital N1 by L into I1 into A is equal to M21 I1. Both sides I1, I1 cancel. So the expression for M21, so mutual inductance of second solenoid with respect to first solenoid M21 is equal to formula mu naught capital N1 capital N2 into A by L. The expression for mutual inductance in terms of capital N1 capital R it is also equal to mu naught small n1 into small n2 A into L. Apply n1 value, n2 value, apply multi, simplify means we are getting this one. So that is about expression for mutual inductance of second solenoid with respect to first solenoid. Similarly, previously derived mutual inductance of first solenoid with respect to second solenoid. That is equal to mu naught capital N1 capital N2 A by L. Or that is equal to mu naught small N1 small N2 A into L. Observe M12 and M21. The mutual inductance of first solenoid with respect to second solenoid with respect to first solenoid. Answers becomes remains the same. So expression for the mutual inductance between two coaxial solenoids M12R M21 is equal to mu naught capital N1 capital N2 A by L or mu naught small N1 small N2 A into L. So that is about expression for mutual inductance between two coaxial solenoids. According to this, on what factors mutual induction depends? On what factors mutual inductance between two coaxial solenoids depends? It is depends on mu naught, that means the property of the medium. So it depends on medium between two coils or medium inside the coils. It depends on geometrical terms of geometrical conditions, nothing but dimensions. Dimensions means area, length, number of turns. And third one is also depends on number of turns. And fourth one depends on distance between coils. If distance between two coils is more, mutual induction is less. Distance between two coils is less, mutual induction is less. And also depends on angle between two coils. If two coils arranged parallel, coaxial means induced EMF or mutual inductance is maximum. So angle value changes, mutual inductance is also changes. So that is about expression for mutual induction between or mutual inductance between two coaxial solenoids. So that is about end of today's class. Thank you, one and all.